What's going on, everybody? This is Clay from Tales of the Blade, back with another episode of Gaming Nation, hosted by Fandoms Anonymous. Tonight, we got a really great topic. You know, it's that holiday season. We got the whole lineup of everything you can imagine, things that we saw at E3, things teased from however long ago. It's finally coming out. It's that time of year. It's time to start looking at what you're going to be getting underneath that tree, or just as a gift you're going to give to somebody or give to yourself. Of course, you know, I got my team with me here tonight. I got Mr. Inferno himself, Mr. Daryl Blackson. What's going on, man?
Man, what's up? How y'all doing tonight?
You know, we're feeling good. We're feeling good. And, of course, D-Braz, Dan, what's going on?
Hey, what's up, Gaming Nation? So happy to be back here. What's up? What's up? We're about to bring you a great episode today, guys.
Absolutely, absolutely. I think it's going to be really, really great. We'll see what happens. So let's just start off the top. So, of course, we're talking about holiday season games, things that we're looking forward to, and we hope that you guys are looking forward to as well. So let's get started. Let's get right into it. Daryl, let's talk about some of the games that you're looking forward to, man. What caught your eye for this holiday season?
Destiny 2. I mean, I played the beta, and the beta was great. I am definitely looking to Destiny 2. Now, I know we had some problems with Destiny 1. We had a lot of problems with Destiny 1. It wasn't what we thought of. But I think Bungie is really going to do it with this game right here. So I'm definitely looking forward to Destiny 2.
I have to agree. I mean, I didn't really get a chance to play the beta. How was that, by the way?
The beta was awesome. I mean, we didn't get a lot, but it's a beta. I mean, they just gave us a little bit, okay? It gave us a taste. I mean, they left a lot out. And, you know, I think that was good. It's just like in movie trailers. I hate when a movie trailer shows so much. So they didn't give us too much, but they gave us enough to make you want to play it. So I'm definitely, you know, going to get Destiny 2.
And in that, I mean, you really got to kind of go, you know, got to think about the fact that when they show a trailer for, like, a movie or even a video game, sometimes they have a tendency to show the best bit. So I hope that's not what they're going to do to us because, yeah, Bungie, like you said, they didn't really give us a whole lot with Destiny 1. And at least it wasn't what we expected it to be, what we were hoping it was going to be. But they are a group that came off of, you know, mostly single-player first-person shooter, even though it had some great multiplayer functions from game to game. But in terms of the MMO game, which is what they're getting into now, they're still really young, and I just hope that Bungie learned something from Destiny 1. I heard a lot of good things. I also heard a lot of bad things, but we'll see what happens. Dan, what are you looking at this holiday season, my friend?
Oh, man, I'm super excited. I'm kind of breaking it down month by month by month and kind of what I'm seeing. I think Christmas came a little early this year because in August, this month, the end of this month, I'm looking at a bunch of great titles to come out. We got Madden 18 for all the gaming fans of sports, and this is always the time. As soon as Madden comes out, I always think, okay, here comes all the good games. And I was not wrong. We got Mario Rabbids Kingdom Battle, and then we got Uncharted The Lost Legacy, and this is the one that we saw at E3 with the two girls. Super excited about that, and that's just in August. Now we go over to September, and a few ones that I see. Daryl already talked about Destiny 2. That comes out September 5th. And then we go on down, and for my sports gamers, 2K18 comes out, but then right next to it, Marvel vs. Capcom, the brand new one. I'm super excited. I always love playing these games. I love playing fighting games. Also that month, Pokemon Tournament DX comes out, and which we talked about in our last show, the Super NES Classic Edition comes out, and that's, I already have one on pre-order, guys. I'm getting it, man. I have to get that system. And then we go into October, and there's some good titles. We got some Shadow of War. The WWE 2K18 comes out. But then I was looking, and November is where things get shaky and are really for Xbox. They have the new system, the X, Crackdown 3, Forza Motorsport 7. They got the new Call of Duty WW2 coming out. There's a lot of good stuff, but I think the game that's got my eye is Battlefront 2 and Pokemon Ultra Moon and Ultra Sun. So I kind of just, I broke it down on what I really saw month by month, because, you know, I feel like once a month I'm probably buying a game. I'm getting something. And so I've got a lot of options. You know, maybe someone's listening right here that's going to give me a gift. Now you know what I want, people. Christmas time, baby. Back
hey,
to you, brother.
Hey, look up us on Facebook, the Facebook group, and we'll give you his information. Y'all can send him a gift. So I want to back you up. Yeah, man. You were talking about, I want to like kind of break this down like game by game. You were talking about some of the ones that you were looking forward to. So actually right off the bat, I want to look at Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite. I'm right there with you with, you know, liking that like from its earlier days. But, you know, it really hit just kind of this brick wall of iniquity that a lot of people just really didn't get down with the last installment, which was Marvel vs. Capcom 4 Ultimate, or 3 or 4 Ultimate, whichever one it was. So I really hope they turn it around. So far from what I've seen of the story, it's going to be really interesting. I mean, you got Ultron apparently having fused with Sigma from Mega Man X. So the story itself is really interesting. It had a beta that you could play like the first little bit of story, but It didn't go much further than that, and I didn't play it myself, so I'm not really knowing what to expect. But that's just the thing. I didn't want to play it because I want to get the full experience. And of course, I got the Collector's Edition, the Super Collector's Edition pre-order with the 6 Infinity Stones and the 4 individual statues of Mega Man, Chun Li, Captain Marvel, and Iron Man. So I'm really excited about it. So we'll see what happens.
I'm a little disappointed in that game, you know, with the character lineup. I hope they add some new characters in because, I mean, what, he's like, what, 24 characters, I think?
Yeah, so far.
Yeah. You know, usually we get, like, a ton. We get, like, 50 to 60 characters. I mean, I don't know why they went with, you know, less characters on this one. So I was a little disappointed with that, but I am still excited about that game. But it's one thing I want to bring up when he talked about November. It is a game that's coming out in November looking forward to. It's The Sims 4. PS4.
Okay.
And I'm wondering, you know, is it going to be just like PC? Because we all know that, you know, the PC version is way better than the console version. The console version of The Sims always been watered down and washed down. But I read in the article that they said it's not going to be like that. They said they're going to be get the full experience. So I've been trying to read, and I didn't hear if it's going to be the exact same experience. I just seen what they said. They're not gonna give us a watered down experience this time. So if The Sims 4 is just like it is on PC, I'm definitely picking it up in November.
I definitely have to agree with you. You know, I've run into The Sims a lot, and it was always just seems like it was always just so much better for the PC. I mean, I remember love buying like different skins and things like that, and just downloading all that, and just loading in there and building my own world however I wanted. I had like the nerdiest hangouts ever. I had like TVs with like anime running on them and all kinds of like game posters on there that you could download. It was cool.
Oh, yes. Man. I really, really hope they do really, really good with the console version.
I really hope so too, man. I really do. I'll be looking at that for sure. Dan mentioned the SNES Classic Mini. I think that was actually kind of funny because he plugged that one a little bit after he won in the last episode of our three console 1v1, B1, beat down. He had to come back and bring that one back. Thanks, Dan.
Hey, you guys can toot my horn. I can toot my horn. We can all toot the horn.
But, yeah, I think that's a really solid lineup, man. But, I mean, everything that's coming out this year, and it's really hard to say because I'm looking at everything right now. And, oh, the Xbox One X console. I mean, let's talk about that for a second. Of course, you know, they teased that and they showed, you know, what it could do at E3, which was mainly with Minecraft, which I don't know why they went that route. But what do you guys think? Do you think the Xbox One X is going to be big this holiday season? I mean, obviously it's a new console, so there's going to be some hype with it, but do you guys really think it's going to be market-breaking? What do you guys think?
I mean, I honestly feel like this. It's like we've been saying before, okay? I mean, you can have this big old giant gun, but if you don't got the ammo, it's worthless. It's nothing but a paperweight. So, I mean, they got a brand of games. I mean, the only exclusive I see that's probably worth anything is Crackdown. every other game is multi-platform, okay, so I can get this on another system. So why do I need to spend $500? They haven't shown me why I should spend $500 on that console. And I'm thinking other players are looking at that. I mean, of course, the Xbox fanboys is going to buy it, but how are you going to get other people to buy your console? You haven't shown us anything. Yes, you're going to have the most powerful console out there, but what do I get with it? What can I use with this console? And Xbox hasn't shown me, Microsoft hasn't shown me that yet.
Solid reasoning. Dan, how about you, man?
Okay, so the thing with the Xbox One X is Microsoft acts like they have a brand new system. It's really like PlayStation has a missile with like 100 explosives on it, and the One X has a missile with like 110 explosives on it. Like, they finally leveled up just to get those 4K graphics, and I'm looking at the games, and like, it's basically like the Xbox One games will play on an Xbox One, but then they have the special games that are like One X compatible. So it's not even like you're getting a fully new system. You're just getting an Xbox that's more upgraded that could do this stuff that your old one that you put your money into can't do. So it's really just a ploy to get you to spend more money, in my opinion. I don't think it's going to hit like they think it's going to hit, because you can still play these games on your Xbox One.
Mm-hmm.
That's true.
You just won't get them in 4K, but I mean, just come over to PS4 and you can get like 85% of like all the games are in 4K. There's only like a few games that aren't in 4K.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't think it will be a huge, like, honestly, the way that Microsoft's going, it wouldn't surprise me in a few years if they just pulled out of the gaming realm completely.
I mean,
I think they'll sell the Xbox to another company. You know, maybe Apple might buy it.
Oh, God.
Oh, yeah. Someone will buy it.
Hey, you know, Apple had a console before, right?
Yeah,
you know, the Pippin. They had the Pippin. So don't count Apple out of it. You know, Apple might come one day and say, hey, I want to join the console market again. You know, the Pippin was a big console,
yeah,
just way before its time.
It would be real scary to see Apple try to jump back in the game for sure. I'd like to be honest.
Mm-hmm.
So looking at some of these other games, like Assassin's Creed Origins. Let's talk about that. So that, you know, that was a big hype at E3, and of course it first started off, I think it was at the Xbox One conference, if I'm not mistaken, that jumped in there and they started to show that. As far as my experience with Assassin's Creed, and if you guys have watched the channel, you know what I'm talking about. I've come a long way with Assassin's Creed. Of course, I played from the first one all the way through Syndicate without having played some of the console, or the handheld console, rather, and some of the side-scrollers that they released along with Syndicate. But it looks like, honestly, they've changed so much, and I'm personally really excited about it. They got all these amazing new features, like the Eagle Vision actually being an eagle. That was actually kind of mind-blowing for me, and of course, the fighting system looks like, you know, they've been playing a lot off of For Honor, like they use For Honor as their kind of beta for the new combat system for their flagship Assassin's Creed. So Ubisoft looks like they're playing one up for sure with that, and of course I'm looking forward to that this holiday season. There's a couple of new IPs actually I was looking at down here in December that's coming out, and the first one is what's that place called? Frostpunk. And we saw that at E3. It's like this big this big city, kind of in this like vast Arctic wasteland looking thing, and that really intrigues me, because I'm really into playing games that are like post-apocalyptic, like The Last of Us, and what's some of the other ones that I've played? Anyway, there's quite a few. Sorry, Fallout. Yeah.
Fallout. Yeah.
Definitely Fallout. So I'm always very interested to see how they build these dystopian societies inside of like harsh conditions, like vast wastelands, especially like a frozen tundra, which is, you know, no man's land. Like, so many people fear going into the Arctic or the Antarctica, because it's just such hostile conditions that are conditions that really just house no life that exists kind of mid hemisphere, at least on this planet. So we'll see how that goes and how much it's really going to kind of feel. It's always very interesting. Speaking of games that feel, the other IP I'm looking at is this game called Agony. And this has always been a genre that's been really popular lately. It's been about like survival horror games. You know, you guys know what I'm talking about? Like Five Nights at Freddy's.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
So that's been Five Nights at Freddy's.
It's been like a really big genre that's kind of come out into the mainstream. And this one is kind of takes that to a whole new level. It actually puts you in this situation where you're basically trying to make your way through hell, like the literal location they're in, and survive the horrors they're in. I'm curious to see it. It sounds a little morbid, but I'm actually kind of interested to see it. So y'all check that one out as well.
Yeah, I'm definitely gonna check that out, because I haven't heard that one. I haven't seen any gameplay of it, so I'm gonna check this out when we finish.
Check out the trailer for it. It's called Agony. It's
Agony. Yeah.
Saw it, like the opening of it was like this person like falling through this big open abyss, and I have this issue with heights as it is, so seeing that and like this dude just falling into like this gaping maw of this like black hole, it was creepy. So we'll see how that works. I'm into horror games. We'll see how many times I can get scared playing that game. I don't know. So like out of those lists that we just gave, guys, what would you guys say is your favorite to your least favorite? Dan, let's start with you.
Okay, I think my favorite, just because I'm a huge Pokemon fan, I got to go with that Ultra Moon and Ultra Sun. Super excited to see what new Pokemon, if any, because I know that this is like an Ultra version, like remake, to the Sun and Moon, but I hear there's going to be extra Pokemon, extra things to catch. And also, with a tie, I have to give it to the new Metroid game. I think that has been long overdue for a really good handheld game on the 3DS. Now, there's one game that I was looking at that I was kind of like, I thought it was a cheap knockoff, but then Microsoft is actually the one putting it out, and I don't know if they're trying to make a new character, but there is this weird game, guys, called Super Lucky's Tale, and I'm looking at this. It's going to be coming out for the Xbox One and the One X compatible November 7th, and it looks like they took, like, Mega Man, but they fused him with Tails from Sonic. I'm not even joking. He's like a little, I don't even know if he's like a fox squirrel type thing with his orange tail. Looks just like Tails, but it's a Microsoft game, and it looks cheesy and a full knockoff. And I'm just, maybe I'm wrong, maybe it will be a cult classic, but I'm just looking at a few of these pictures of it, and I'm just like, oh my God, they're totally ripping off everybody else with this one.
No, I just pulled it up, and it honestly, it does look like they kind of went with almost like a Skylanders cutesy to what's that game for Little Big Planet? You guys know what I'm talking about?
Yes.
With Sackboy.
Yes.
Yeah. That's what it looks like, man. It honestly, wow. Oh, you know, Little Big Planet did well, so maybe Lucky's Tale will do something. See.
Yeah, when I saw it, I thought it was Tails at first. I was like, wait, are they giving Tails his own game? And I looked, and I'm like, oh, no, that's Lucky. So, yeah, they got you there a little bit.
Tails needs his own game for sure. I mean, that man has always kind of been in Sonic's shadow, but, you know, honestly, some of the missions in Sonic, some of the classic ones at least, he wouldn't be able to do anything without Tails, especially with that plane of his.
Yeah.
Yeah. What kind of crap is that, guys? I mean, like Luigi gets his own game, Wario gets his own game, but Tails has been the sidekick for over 25 years, and he can't get his own game. I'm with you, man.
You heard it right here on Gaming Nation, Nintendo. Make sure Tails gets his own game this holiday season or next year. Do something about that. Daryl, what about you, man?
Well, I'm really most excited about the Sims 4. Like I said, you know, it's been a long time since the Sims game has been good on consoles. And since these consoles are now, you know, are more PC-like, I mean, they can probably give us a good Sims game that we need. I mean, like I said, I love playing the Sims. I mean, I could spend hours, you know, just killing my Sims and then calling the Grim Reaper and bringing them back to life. I mean, I have a blast doing it. And oh, yeah. Especially Destiny 2. I mean, I'm definitely looking forward to Destiny 2. Playing the beta, it really made me feel like, you know, now Destiny 2 is going to be really good. I mean, they're going to give us what they should have gave us the first time. So, and then, you know, playing a game with friends. I mean, me, I love multiplayer games. I love playing with a friend. So, Destiny 2, I mean, I just hope, you know, it's not how Division was. Like, Division game, the beta was great. I mean, it was great. But then the main game, it just, the more and more you played, the more and more you kind of got bored with it. So I just hope, you know, it ain't too much hype behind it. Now, the game I'm least looking forward to, a lot of people are looking forward to it, but I'm not looking forward to Call of Duty, you know, World War II. I mean, I'm not looking forward to that at all. I know they're going back to, you know, the basics. I feel like they're going back to where Call of Duty was good, like, you know, Modern Warfare 3 and Modern Warfare 2, those days. I feel like they're going back to that, but I'm just not excited about Call of Duty. Call of Duty has screwed me too many times, and I'm not looking forward to that game at all.
No, I'm going to have to agree with you, and I really hope my friend who actually works for Activision is not currently listening to this, or will in the future at some point. Jamie, I love you, buddy, but Call of Duty has to end. I'm sorry. It's done.
Wait. Well, I want him to prove me wrong. I mean, to me, I love being proven wrong, because if you prove me wrong, that means you're going to give me something good. So prove me wrong. So, Jamie, if you listen to this, prove me wrong, please. Okay, make me regret not pre-ordering this game.
All right, yeah, no, for sure. I mean, you know, maybe one day they'll get away from their formula. They seem to work with a whole lot. It seems to just breed just such a bad time in terms of the first player, the Sinclair story, may not be so bad, but experience on the multiplayer, which of course is not the game's fault necessarily. It's more the community thing. Just sometimes it gets a little toxic in there. It really does. Honestly, I'm gonna have to side with you for sure on that one, Daryl. Destiny 2 is definitely standing out for me, and you and me are gonna have to hook up later on the PS4, and we'll play that when it comes out and just check it out and see what happens. Okay. That and Assassin's Creed Origins, for sure. Least favorite. I don't know. I really don't. Oh, that's a hard one. No. I really don't have a least favorite. I'm that kind of weeaboo. I mean, when it comes to games, I'm always open to try something new, except for Call of Duty. But we'll see what happens with all that. I always just try to play games, and just, we'll see what happens, you know, whether or not it's good or bad. So looking at all these, which console, PC included, do you guys think is really going to give the biggest bang for our buck this holiday season?
I mean, it's a system who always does it. It's going to be, well, they'll be in a tie. And, well, you know what? I'm going to squash this. I'm going to give it to Nintendo. I think Nintendo's going to win it, because they got the NFC on the Super NES Classic coming out. It's already sold out already. Okay, they got Mario Odyssey with Mario Rabbit. So I think Nintendo is going to give us the best this year with all the new third-party games that the Switch is getting too. So I think Nintendo is probably going to win it this year.
Okay, that's pretty bold. Dan, what do you think, man?
You know what? I couldn't agree more with Daryl. I do think that this is, and don't get it messed up, but this is the year of that the Xbox is going to try everything to put itself back on top, which I don't think it's going to happen. You can tell that PlayStation has a lot of great games coming out, but there's not too many exclusives that just, like, are all about the PS4. I mean, we have Uncharted. We have a few other games that are good, but a lot of the big games that are dropping this holiday season are for the Xbox and the PlayStation. And really, for bang for my buck, when I'm looking at it, and I'm looking at some games, I'm looking at the 3DS, and they got Metroid and the good old Pokemon coming out. Then they got this game called Coldcept Revolt. It's supposed to be a really good game. So we're sitting, I know there's only a few, like, 4 3DS games coming out for that holiday season, but when we're talking bang for your buck, when you're releasing IPs like Pokemon and an IP like Metroid, that's all you need. And then we talk about the Switch, they're releasing good games too, and that's where we go bang for your buck. If you're going to go put your money, obviously we could say PlayStation because they have the better console. But when we're saying bang for your buck, where you can get the good games, you know, I can go in for $100, I could buy Pokemon games and the Metroid game and walk out of there, you know? So my money's going with Nintendo.
Exactly. I mean, I felt the exact same way. That's why I had to change that. At first, I was going to lean towards PlayStation, but I had to think about exclusives. You know, PlayStation got a lot of games that's coming out, but it's going to be for PlayStation and Xbox. So, exactly. I mean, I'm feeling the exact same way how you feel.
I mean, I have to agree with both of you on that one. I mean, just based on that alone, it really does, you know, seem to be that Nintendo is really coming hard this year. I mean, if you want to talk about exclusive console, yeah, the Switch has got some great stuff. The 3DS, just with the two Pokemon games alone, which, of course, is a big deal. Big, big deal. They're coming out with another, you know, set of two, but then they got Samus Returns. That alone, well, of course, I'm a huge Metroid fan, that alone for me would be enough to run the 3DS as far as my big console. I'm going to have to give it to Nintendo in general, though, for the Switch, the 3DS, and, of course, the Super NES Classic. We talked about that before. That's just amazing. I think that Nintendo is going to make big this year, and I think everybody, all gamers need to jump in and just be behind Nintendo this year, because it's going to be so huge for them. They're really pushing hard. They're coming out with some great stuff, and it's going to be awesome. I really do think. Daryl, before the show started, we were talking about games that we wanted to see in the fall lineup, and you seem really excited, so I'm going to let you have this next one. What did you want to see in this fall lineup that was not there?
I wanted to see it, but it's like I knew it wasn't going to be here, but I was hoping it was going to be here. And I was hoping it wasn't going to be here, but I knew it was just crazy. RDR 2. I wanted Red Dead Redemption 2 so bad. I wanted it so bad, but I know Rockstar, okay? And Rockstar is not going to put out anything that's trash. They're going to make sure it's perfect. So I don't want Rockstar to put out anything that's bad. So if it's going to be bad, don't put it out. But I just wanted it. But then I didn't want it because I felt like it was going to be bad. Like, hold on, if Rockstar put it out now, it's not going to be good because they don't seem like Rockstar. But I just wanted Red Dead Redemption 2 so bad. I mean, I was hoping and praying that it was going to be here. I was telling my friend, like, no way, it's going to be here. It's going to be here. And he's like, no, it's not going to be here. You know it's not going to be here. You know it's not going to be here. Like, I know it's not going to be here, but it's going to be here.
And, you know, I almost saw that coming because, during the RE3 episode, we were talking about the games that they didn't show that we really wish they did, and you got super big on Red Dead Redemption 2. So, now I'm right there with you, man. That's no doubt. Dan, what do you think, man?
You know what? I really, really wanted to see the new God of War come out. I know it's coming out in 2018. When I first saw that preview, the trailer we all saw, I was like, ooh, hopefully it will be ready by holidays, which wasn't the case, but that was a game that it could have really changed the whole scenario for PlayStation for us. I know it's only one game, but we just talked about with the 3DS, they only had four games they're coming out with, you know? Sony comes out with an exclusive game like that, and then this holiday season, they probably sell way more systems, you know? So I do think that this would have been the game changer for PlayStation, but at least they have something to hold on to down the line. Like, they have that curveball that they're going to throw, but they're just not going to throw it yet. And that's kind of mine. At least we're getting it. I'm not really mad, you know. Like, we're still going to get it in the next year, but I was really hoping that they would just surprise us and drop that God of War. Like, just be like a Beyonce and drop that album in the middle of the night, man. Let us get that.
No, for real, though, for real. That would have been really cool to see in that lineup that God of War was planning to come out. But, you know, like, you know, we said before, we want them to take their time. We want to make sure that they don't release garbage. And Sony Santa Monica, they kind of hurt us with the last God of War they dropped. It wasn't all that great. So I really want to see something just stellar as they try to bring back a new generation of God of War with the upgraded combat system, the upgraded graphics, the new story. We'll see where it goes. I'm actually really excited about it. Well, guys, that does it for this particular episode. We hope you guys enjoyed it. We hope you guys are looking forward to this holiday season in terms of all the games that are coming out. Look up the list. We'll post a link in the description below, so make sure to check that out. And that's all we got. We thank y'all for listening in. And, of course, we're going to go around. Daryl, where can we find you, sir?
Man, you can find me always on a Fan of Anonymous group, and you can find me on Inferno Share Place.
That's it. That's it. Dan, how we doing? Where can we find you, man?
Okay, first of all, you can find me on Facebook and YouTube at The Fan Club, or check me out on Facebook, D-B-R-O-Z-D, Broz. And like always, catch me here every Wednesday holding it down for Gaming Nation with the homies. Thank you guys so much for having me.
Hey, man, it's always good to have you. And, of course, you guys know who I am. I'm Clay from Tales of the Blade. You can find us on YouTube.com/Tales of the Blade, also Facebook.com/Tales of the Blade, and right here on Fandoms Anonymous every Wednesday for Gaming Nation. And, of course, if you don't know who we are Fandoms Anonymous. That is FANDOMANONYMOUS. We're all over social media. You can check us out on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. You can check out the Facebook group page. Please come by and hang out. Check out all the topics that are being talked about there. It's always a good time. And, of course, as they always say, if there is anything else, thank you for listening, and have a great day. Fandoms Anonymous.